So we decided to create Coming Full Circle Loud and Clear, where we are going to rebuild lives, heal families, and we are going to support recovery. Coming Full Circle Loud and Clear aftercare program was designed to be all-encompassing. Anything a person needs to gain a productive, independent, happy, and healthy life can be found here in our programs. From our TK Go program that helps people find jobs and career build, to our crisis intervention team, and to our Monday meditation. Everything is created to build off of the next. Our programs look to heal the individual and their family using a holistic approach. Simply, Coming Full Circle, Loud and Clear, motivates with passion, inspires with purpose, and turns dreams into a reality.
Is there any state in this country that does not have an opioid or heroin crisis?
No. Definitely not.
At the time, Lynn and Daniel told us they turned their own experience with addiction into a mission to help others, starting a treatment center out of their home called CFC Loud and Clear. Since last sharing their story with Crime Watch Daily, Daniel and Lynn tell us CFC Loud and Clear has been able to help more people than ever before.
How does your son, raised well, loved, become a heroin addict at 17 years old?
We had a lot of trauma in our life that John was very affected by. My brother died on 9/11. He was in the World Trade Center. My son was 12, and he was very close with my brother. We were all a very close family, and then it was shattered after that.
But at the end of it all, there was hope. After the hospital, John completed a treatment program in California, and today lives and works alongside Lynn and Daniel Regan at the CFC Loud and Clear Center in Howell, New Jersey.
Is John a success story?
Absolutely. He has come completely to the other side, and he wants to help others also. He wants to start his counseling degree. He has already started taking his facilitator license to start running groups here at CFC. He is fully engaged in the program and is living a life in recovery.
And John says if he could find the power to change, anyone can.
I just want people to know that that there's hope. There's hope out there for anyone. There's always a way. Just talk to somebody and don't hold back.
How long do you have?
I attend CFC Family Group every week. It's so uplifting. I've made friends. I've made extended family.
I really fell in love with CFC. They told me it was a lot different than other treatment centers. It's nonprofit, and you know all these other treatment centers, they're pretty much just in it for the money.
Every week we come and Lynn Regan has a different topic of encouragement.
That the sober socialization is a beautiful thing in life, because when you're with another person that's been there, done that, and been around that way of life that I was in, and you can connect on both levels.
Sober fun is amazing. She has had opportunities that she never would have had if she didn't have CFC.
Smart Recovery has taught me a more meditative way to recovery instead of just 12 steps.
As we told you on Tuesday, he too was a heroin addict. His days are anything but ordinary. Whether it's 2 p.m. or 2 a.m., the 25-year-old is ready to bolt from his home in Farmingdale, New Jersey, to be with those who have hit rock bottom.
And streaming live on Facebook, and Jim wanted to know, he said, I know three people that went into rehab, and they were in and out, and now all three are dead. And he said, you know, what can be done to fix the rehabs here in New Jersey? So let's end on that. And, you know, maybe there's a solution that we can all work toward.
It's a sad thing. I've lost 27 friends over the past 4 years. Just recently lost my friend's mom just last week to an overdose. Mm. And
God forbid.
It's what happens is people go to rehab and they come back out and they think they could do the same amount that they did going in, and they die. But what could be done about treatment? Treatment could be taken to another level in terms of addressing the individual, addressing the root causes to this addiction, not just addressing symptoms, because that's not curing anything.
Yeah.
And further from that, addiction is, it's a mental illness. It has a mental component. So it's a longitudinal thing. Like, it needs to be done over a vast amount of time and a slow integration back into life to really make sure that those coping skills and all those tools that you learned are being used properly and that you know when to use them. Because you could go over, you should do this or you should do that. But when it comes down to it, I haven't practiced.
It's impacted me by bringing me into, I guess you can call it sort of a sober family. You know, with people that I could rely on or call if I need help with something.
CFC has impacted my life tremendously. I can hardly even put it into words. One thing that I'm thinking of is we went Christmas shopping for a bunch of families.
I found CFC, my mom heard it on the radio. She told me to call. I wasn't quite ready yet, and when I was ready, I gave him a call, and best phone call I made in my life. Lights will guide.